Pu'u Point, and that's Makapu'u Lighthouse on the edge of the cliff. You can park in this parking lot here. There's a nice paved walking path about a mile to the top here. Really pretty views from up there. Before the lighthouse was here, the native Hawaiian people used to light big signal fires on the edge of these cliffs here to help the boats at sea here navigate. Makapu'u means bulging eye in the native language. And down here to the left, this is Sea Life Park. You can see a lot of marine life shows here. You can swim with dolphins here, and good luau's here. And then the island right over here to the right, this is called Rabbit Island. It kind of vaguely looks like a rabbit's face on the right with its ears behind it to the left. One of the few islands here, though, that you're actually not allowed to visit, it's a seabird sanctuary today. So the entire island is reserved for seabird nesting grounds. And then you have this long stretch of sandy beach over here to the left. This is Waimanalo Beach. This is actually the longest stretch of uninterrupted sandy beach on Oahu, about 5 miles long. Really great place to come if you get tired of all the crowds at Waikiki. Just drive over here, you can find a big stretch of sandy beach all to yourself here. Especially on the weekdays, almost no one here on the weekdays. The two little islands up here to the front right. Hang on 1 second. So these are the Mokulua Islands, also known as the Mokes, and you can visit these islands, you can kayak out to them. The far one there has a little beach, that one's called Moku Nui. The one closer to us here is called Moku Iki. These are actually the most photographed islands in the entire state of Hawaii. The big reason for that is there's a hike on this ridge up ahead here called the Lanikai Pillbox Hike, where you can hike up to two World War II bunkers that are still there. So photographers will hike up here in the early morning and photograph the sun rising between the two islands. I'll make a quick radio call to this airport up ahead here. This little beach here with my daughter a couple weeks ago. There was a big seal just sitting on the beach right there. Pretty cool. This is the town of Kailua over here on the left. Really nice town here on the windward side of the island. I live in Kailua by this little lake on the left here. That's actually the truth this time. A lot of nice restaurants and shopping here in downtown Kailua. Really pretty beach here as well, Kailua Beach. Really soft, powdery sand, several beach parks here as well. You could usually find parking at one of the beach parks. Drive here from Honolulu, the quickest route is right through the Ko'olau Mountains on the left here. You see that dip in the mountains, that's the Pali Pass, P-A-L-I. Really pretty drive through the mountains. It's also a historic site. It's where King Kamehameha defeated the chief of Oahu to unite the Hawaiian Islands. This really big bay up ahead here, this is Kaneohe Bay. Really pretty bay, a lot of coral formations in the bay, tons of marine life here as well. There's sea turtles, seals, sometimes dolphins swim into the bay. The occasional manta ray spotted here, as well as the occasional tiger shark and hammerhead shark. The town of Kaneohe on the left here, and on this big peninsula in front of us, this is Kaneohe Marine Corps Base. This was one of the airports that was attacked during the attack on Pearl Harbor. This little island right over here to the front left, this is called Coconut Island. If you guys remember the TV show Gilligan's Island, some of Gilligan's Island was filmed right here. Today it's a marine life research institute ran by the University of Hawaii, but you can still visit and tour the island today. Here it's a 3-hour tour. This whole time Gilligan could have just swam ashore right here, who knew? See all the coral formations here in the bay. As this coral has grown and eroded over time, it created this really big sandbar in the middle of the bay up ahead here. This is Kaneohe Sandbar. A really fun thing to do if you come over here to this side of the island, you can hop on a tour boat that will take you out to the sandbar. You can also rent a boat or kayak from some of the marinas here in the bay, come out to the sandbar on your own. Water's pretty shallow over the sandbar. It's about waist deep most places. There's even a little exposed beach down here at really low tide. Really good snorkeling out here, good fishing, pretty views looking back at the mountains. This big catamaran here on the right, this is one of the tour boats that will bring you out here. They pull a big floating lounge out onto the sandbar. You can hang out on the floating lounge and they have live music on the boat. Really fun. Do a little rain shower up here, just a second. This is some of the healthiest coral anywhere around Oahu, all these circular formations down here. And this little island straight ahead here, this is called Mokoli'i, also known as Chinaman's Hat. And you can visit that island, you can kayak or paddleboard out to it. Some people even swim to the island from Kualoa Beach, the little beach up ahead here. There's a little hike that will take you to the top of the island, really pretty views. A local legend here is that a goddess fought a giant lizard in the mountains up ahead, and she pulled his tail off and threw it into the ocean, so that's the tip of the lizard's tail sticking up there. Mokoli'i translates to Lizard Island. These two ponds right up ahead here, these are the Moli'i fish ponds. They're a historic site, believed to have been built between 600 and 900 years ago. So the Hawaiian people built a seawall out into the bay here, and one little entrance to the ponds at the end of the wall here, so small fish could swim in, and then the fish would eventually grow too large to swim back out. It was a big fish trap. Here to the left, this is the Kualoa Ranch. It's a big cattle ranch here. You can do a lot of fun activities out of the ranch here. You can go horseback riding, zip lining, and go on ATV tours. On your ATV tour out of the ranch here, you'll enter this really pretty valley that's about to come into view on the left. It's called the Ka'ava Valley. And this valley is, famous for a lot of movies and TV shows filmed here, like Jurassic Park, Jurassic World, Godzilla, Kong Skull Island, TV show Lost, Hawaii Five-O, Magna P.I. You could go on and on, almost 100 movies and TV shows have at least some scenes filmed here. We'll fly into the valley, do a quick turn here, come back out.